Farmington. I'm Nehemiah Rocket.
And I'm Dana Bender.
And welcome to this week's edition of Focus on This. So Jenna has a big AP exam, so she wasn't able to join us, but I have my good friend Dana here. Dana, how's it going?
Good. I'm glad to be here. Nehemiah, what are you doing this weekend?
I don't have that many plans. Like, I think, chill at home. Parents are out of town. They're going to Iowa for my brother's basketball tournament. Sadly, I couldn't join them because I had to work. But what about you?
I am getting my shoes for prom.
What? You're going to prom?
Well, yeah, I'm going to Rosemont's prom, but...
I didn't get asked. I don't really know why. Maybe I'm just not...
Oh. Do you hear that?
If you didn't understand that, that was translated from elephant language to, it's time to listen up, Farmington.
That's right, that's right. Researchers have found that elephants have hundreds of distinct signals and gestures.
Yep, elephant biologists and conservationists have developed an online database showing all those signals.
That's right, and among the categories of signals and gestures is play. And one thing that they do is they tusk the ground. It means they're mad.
Communication is key.
That's right.
And if you're a dog person, you may have more in common with your fellow dog owners than you actually realize.
Yep, new research shows that two strangers who both own dogs are more likely to share similar skin bacteria than a married couple without a dog in the home.
Yep, the study also found that dogs have more skin bugs in common with their owners than actual dogs themselves.
That's right. Researchers examined the skin of people who live together, couples, couples with dogs, couples with children, and couples with children and dogs, and found that the family dog, very generously, and he doesn't have to do that, so that's pretty nice, shares his skin bugs with the entire family.
Yep, the group with dogs in their home shared more skin bacteria than any other groups studied.
That's right. Not surprisingly, doggy affection is behind all this sharing. Dogs transmit their skin molecules to their people via tongue to skin, skin to skin, or paw to skin contact.
Yep, and if you're not a dog person, this might gross you out a little bit.
Even if you are, it should still gross you out. Dogs are... Ugh. It was the biggest beehive that Ogden beekeeper Vic Bakken has ever removed. 12 feet long, packed inside the eave of a cabin in Ogden Valley.
Yeah, they figured they got about 15 pounds of bees.
Oh,
and if you
goodness.
Didn't know, that translates to 60,000 bees.
That is
bees.
A lot. Oh, funny. I do not like bees at all. Bakken was called to the A-frame cabin last month in Eden, Utah, taking apart a panel that hid roof rafters. He had no idea he would find honeycombs packed 12 feet long, 4 feet wide, and 16 inches deep.
Yep, the honeybees have been making this enclosed cavity their home since 1996.
There's some busy bees. The cabin was rarely used, but when the owners needed to occupy it while building another home nearby, they decided the beehive wasn't safe for their two children.
I don't know about you, Devin, but no one knows bees better than a huza bee.
That's right, that's right. Hey, Farmington, that's it for this week. Tune in next week to hear how a mom accidentally won $14 million.
Back to you guys.
You know, I've never been stung by a bee, and I really hope that I never have to go through that experience.
I've had the fortune of not being stung. Unfortunately, I've been stung by a wasp. That hurt pretty bad. Don't ever want that to happen again. But you know what? We'll be right back after this.
You know what to do.
Red.
Gold.
Pink.
Blue.
Power Rangers!
Go, go, Power Rangers! Go, go, Power Rangers!
They're over there. That does not go in the organics.
Chip bags are not compostable. Trash this.
These are not compostable. Remember, friends, be smart and be green.
Power Rangers.
smart, be green. Brought to you by the Mean Green Recycling Team.
Welcome back.
As you all know, we had the blood drive earlier this week, and it was a big success. Dr. Oz got a chance to check it out. Let's take a look.
Hey, Dr. Oz Jr. here. Today, we're at the blood drive.
Perfect. You don't have to give it to me.
You see it in there.
Hey, Nehemiah.
Hey.
How you doing?
Pretty good. I'm nervous. Giving you blood.
All right, so is this the first time you gave blood?
Indeed.
This is the very first time. You scared?
A little bit. I'm a little scared. You know, I've never given blood before.
You know, you don't have to be nervous. It's just going to be like, what, 2-3-inch needle in your veins.
Yeah.
Not a big deal.
Taking a pint of blood, that's kind of a lot of blood, but...
What is that, like an eighth of all the blood in your body? Not even a big deal. Okay, so I'm here with...
Kayleen Sire.
All right, and it was your first time giving blood. Tell us how it was.
Yeah, it was pretty good. I was nervous at first, but it was good.
Didn't hurt at all?
Not really, no.
Not really? All right, that's great. So what's this you're going over right now?
They have you read it. You read it, and then like it tells you how your experience, like what you will experience, and what to expect, I guess.
So, that's pretty cool. Yeah. That's pretty cool. All right, so we're gonna go down this row of people, and I'm gonna ask you guys to give me your name, and then on a level of 1 to 10, how scared you are right now to give blood. 10 being the most, 1 being the least. All right, go.
Garrett Weeking, like -5, cool as a cucumber.
Nice.
Leah Zach and Zara, I'm not scared at all.
Oh, fearless.
Naomi Phillips, 1, not really scared.
All right.
Patrick Shea and 0.
You're gonna be a lot, aren't you?
Brandon Heller and like a 0.6.
0.6, like it.
Miranda Larson, I'm pushing 11.
11. All right, she's a little scared.
Katie Zitzman, like 1.
1, well, I'd 10 to that.
Cheyenne Spursum, 5.
5. All right, mixed. People are scared. People are not. We got a fearless clan here today. Let's give blood. All right, so now I'm here with...
Miss Pemble.
Miss Polk.
And what are you guys doing here?
Miss Polk and I are the NHS advisors, and so we help organize the blood drive with the Red Cross representative.
All right, so do you guys do this every year, or just like every other, or what?
We do this twice a year, once in the spring and once in the fall.
So what are you doing now?
Eating some snacks.
Just getting refreshed and stuff. What snacks are you eating? Cookies?
Fruit snacks and cookies, yeah.
Awesome. That's a great, well-balanced meal you got right here. It's awesome. So how much blood do you guys expect to be donated today?
Well, we have over 100 appointments, but some of them do get turned away because they have lack of iron, or maybe they visited some place that might have malaria, Mexico. So those ones will be turned away, but that's why we have so many appointments, is so that we have a little buffer zone.
So as you can see, I mean, a lot of people are either really excited or just scared to death of giving blood, but it's all for a good cause, and it's gonna go to someone who really needs it. So next time there's a blood drive, sign up, make sure you help out, you know, help out your community, help out anyone that needs it. And that's it for me. Back to you guys.
Thanks for that, Alex. You know, I had quite the interesting experience. They had to take blood from both arms. Like, this one, she didn't know how to put the needle in, so like she put it in there, and then the blood started coming out, and then the needle came out and it mixed with air, so I guess that's bad. So then they're like, oh, well, let's just do your other arm. So then they did this arm, and then like halfway through, my blood was too thick, and it stopped coming out, and so they weren't able to take my blood. So moral of the story is drink water when you're ready to give blood. But I did get some free treats, so that was nice. That was pretty awesome.
This spring, we had a total of 114 pints of blood donated.
And this fall, we had 91, so that brings us to a total of 205 pints, which is awesome, saving some lives. And shout out to Ms. Pemble for holding my hand while I got blood donated. You know, that was awesome. It helped me lots, lots. But for all you procrastinators out there, Mo Cash has a few ideas on how to ask a girl to prom.
Hey, yo, so you're trying to ask some girl to prom. You know what? I feel you. But some of you is straight tripping when it comes to taking the right steps, all right? You gotta make these chicks swoon.
The definition of swoon is to faint or lose consciousness. swoon.
After you have established interest, you want to hit that curl up on any of her social networks. MySpace, Google Plus, Friendster, Facebook, Schoology. You want to send her a message, let her know that you're smooth. Hey curl, where you going? You're looking good. Come back here in that shirt. All right, last step. Now you want to ask that curl to prom. You got to make a dramatic gesture. And that's how it goes.
Welcome back. Okay, so I think I might try the swoon, you know, for next year when I ask a girl. I think that'd be pretty awesome.
Good luck with that.
Well, we have a guest star this week, Taylor Venz.
Let's check out what he has to say on the Roar.
What is up, students and staff of Farmington High School? I am Nate Redarath, and I'm joined here by Matt Gormaker this week, filling in for Ben Erb, Jamie Scavone.
Howdy.
And our special guest this week, Taylor Venz. How's it going, Taylor Venz?
Pretty good.
I have a picture here of Taylor winning state. Taylor, what did that feel like to win state?
It felt amazing to accomplish my dream. Been thinking about it for a very long time.
Yeah, of course.
What was your first meal after winning state?
Big bowl of butter noodles.
Awesome.
All right, so Taylor, you beat the number one ranked wrestler in the semifinals to go to the state championship round. How'd that feel?
It felt really good. I've been thinking about beating him the entire year, and once it happened, it was just awesome because I thought about it every day, and then it finally came true.
Yeah. Work hard, you accomplish your dreams. All right, what is your favorite takedown? Like, what's the most effective for you?
Probably a high crotch. I use that the most.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. Oh, yeah. All right.
What are your plans after high school?
Hopefully go wrestle D1 somewhere. Yeah.
Do you have any specific college that you want to wrestle at, or
maybe UNI or University of Minnesota would be awesome. But
yeah, awesome. Gophers are good.
Yes, they are.
All right, and then what is your favorite singlet to wear?
Definitely the camo singlet. Those are pretty sweet.
Yeah, you're actually wearing that in this state, the one that you won for state. That's actually pretty cool. But for this week on the Billboard Top 100, it is actually "Can't Hold Us" by Macklemore. What do you guys think about the song?
I absolutely love it. It's one of the best.
Really?
One of the best Macklemore songs.
It is a pretty good song. It's actually a very good song. Matt?
Pretty good. It's better than "I Be Your Man."
Bruno Mars. Taylor, what do you think about it? Yeah? Yeah, I think it's also pretty good. All right, back to you guys in the studio.
All right, so seniors had the chance to vote on their senior favorites and who wanted to win what. So let's take a peek and see who got picked.
Yeah. A beautiful feeling that I
got adrenaline, never giving in. Giving up's not an option, gotta get it in. Witness, I got the heart of 20 men. No fear, go to sleep in the lion's den.
But raffle tickets are on sale next week, Tuesday through Friday, May 14th to the 17th, at lunch for an Xbox 360, and you can win Kinect with that. Anyone can buy. Tickets are 3 for $5 or an arm's length for $10. Winners drawn and announced on Friday afternoon. All proceeds benefit students traveling to France this summer, so it goes for an awesome cause.
Decision day was last week, and many of you wore your shirts and looked fantastic.
Yeah, it was pretty awesome. All right, well, this week we have Mr. Lund playing some musical talents for us, so let's take a look.
Getting older.